Hello children, a very happy morning to you all. Hope all of you are staying very healthy at home, praying for that, okay? Every situation will change, okay? So no worries, no stress. Thinking about our chemistry lesson, we were taking the chapter metals and nonmetals. We compared the physical properties of metals and nonmetals. We discussed the chemical reactions of metals and also we discussed the reactivity series. Hope you understood very clearly. Now, how about discussing some in-text questions related to that topic? Okay, so today we are going to discuss some in-text questions. Come on, let's move to the questions.
Right, children. So here we are going to discuss in text questions from page number 40. See the questions. Give an example of a metal which is a liquid at room temperature, can easily be cut with a knife, is the best conductor of heat and is a poor conductor of heat. So here are the answers. Mercury is the only metal which is a liquid at room temperature. Sodium is an example of a metal which can easily be cut with a knife. Okay, and the best conductor of heat and electricity is silver. Lead is a poor conductor of heat. Okay, so one example is only asked. Here are the answers. Moving to the second question from the same page. Explain the meaning of malleable and ductile. So we know that malleability means it is the ability of a substance to become thin sheets when hammered. So here, malleable material is one that can easily be flattened into thin sheets by hammering. You can see in the picture, gold is made into very thin sheets. Okay. Ductile material is a material that can be easily drawn into thin wires. See here, copper is made into very thin wires. Right. So metals are highly malleable and ductile. Okay, now we will move to in-text questions, page number 46. Why is sodium kept immersed in kerosene oil? You know that sodium is highly reactive with air as well as water. So, if we keep it open, it will catch fire immediately. Therefore, sodium is kept under kerosene oil because sodium is unreactive with kerosene. So here you can see a note, potassium is also kept immersed in kerosene oil for the same reason. See here, this is the picture. You can see sodium is kept in kerosene oil. Moving to the second question. Write the equations for the reaction of iron with steam, calcium and potassium with water. We know that iron reacts only with steam to form the metal oxide and hydrogen. We learned that ferric oxide, C3O4 and hydrogen gas are formed when iron reacts with steam. Iron does not react with normal water or even with hot water. And calcium reacts with water, normal water, and which is also exothermic, but the heat evolved is not sufficient for the hydrogen to catch fire. So it is not a violent reaction, we have already discussed. Then what will happen? The hydrogen gas formed will stick on the metal calcium and which will make calcium metal float on water. This is the equation for the reaction. You can see potassium reacts very violently with even cold water and the reaction is so violent and exothermic that the evolved hydrogen immediately catches fire. So here potassium hydroxide and hydrogen gas and a lot of heat energy is also evolved. In the case of calcium also, heat energy is evolved. Moving to the question number 3. Samples of 4 metals A, B, C and D were taken and added to the following solution one by one. Okay, here you can see 4 different types of metals and 4 different types of metal salt solutions. Okay, so here the question is about displacement reaction. The results obtained have been tabulated as follows. Here you can see in the picture, metal A does not react with iron sulfate, but when it reacts with copper sulfate, displacement takes place. Okay, so we have to, what's the question? So we have to find out which is the most reactive metal among A, B, C, D. What would you observe when metal B is added to a solution of copper sulfate? And also arrange the metals A, B, C, D in order of decreasing reactivity. Okay, so we will see how to solve this question. Okay, now for your reference, the table is added here. Okay, see here, when you take A, okay, with iron sulfate, no reaction, but with copper sulfate, displacement. So the position of A is below iron, okay, below iron and above copper. So below iron and above copper, which is the metal, you can see lead is the metal. So we can just write lead. Actually, we are not asked to find out which metal, but for our reference, we can write A is lead. Okay. B is more reactive than iron. See here, B is more reactive than iron. Okay. But less reactive than zinc. So, what is that? B is more reactive than iron. Okay. But less reactive than zinc. So, in between iron and zinc, nothing is coming. So zinc itself is the metal B. Clear? Okay. And what about C? C is less reactive than iron, copper and zinc. But in silver nitrate, displacement takes place. So which one? Copper itself, right? Okay. So C is copper. And what about D? D in all of them, no reaction. So we can assume that D is silver itself. So here, which is the most reactive metal among lead, zinc, copper and silver? So here the most reactive metal is zinc, that is B, right? So we can conclude B is the most reactive metal. Second question is, what would you observe if B is added to a solution of copper sulfate? So B is zinc. So when zinc reacts with copper sulfate, zinc can displace copper. Okay, so B can displace copper as B is more reactive than copper. Then the reactivity of these metals in the decreasing order. This is a decreasing order. Okay, B is more reactive than A, then C, then D. Hope you understood. Moving to page number 46, question number 4. Which gas is produced when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to a reactive metal? Write the chemical reaction when iron reacts with dilute H2SO4. We know that hydrogen gas is evolved when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to a reactive metal. Similarly, when iron reacts with dilute H2SO4, iron sulfate with hydrogen gas is formed. See, here is the equation for the reaction. Fe plus H2SO4 gives FeSO4 plus hydrogen gas. So question number 5. What would you observe when zinc is added to a solution of iron sulfate and why? We know that zinc is more reactive than iron sulfate. Therefore, displacement reaction will take place, isn't it? and also write a chemical reaction. So here the question is, what would you observe? Okay, so we know that iron sulfate is having a pale green color. So when we add the zinc, gray colored zinc powder into iron sulfate, okay, what will happen? The green color of the solution will change into colorless, and a gray precipitate of iron is formed in the solution. Okay, so here zinc is gray color, iron sulfate was pale green in color. Now zinc sulfate does not have any color, colorless, iron gray colored precipitate formed. Okay, so hope you understood. We will continue in the next class.